guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys are doing well. In today's video, I am going to share with you few questions and answers that you may be asked during your Kohl's one-on-one personal interview. And this is specific to the retail supermarket store, not the corporate roles, especially if you're applying for, say, team member role or things like that. These are the questions, general set of questions that have always been asked. It doesn't mean that you will be asked only these questions. There may be something out of the questions that I'm going to give you as well. So if you have someone who have attended a Kohl's interview and you've been asked any different questions, please feel free to leave it in the comment section below. Let's keep it interactive and help each other. And also, I've uploaded a video regarding the step-by-step Kohl's process a couple of months ago. I'm going to link it somewhere in the description box as well. Check that out and then come back to this one. It just makes more sense. So without wasting much time, let's get started. The age-old question, tell me about yourself. So the answer to this one can never be right or wrong, right? So the only reason the interviewers most of the times ask this question is to just know a little bit about yourself. And this is a nice way to just ease into the actual interview process. So you can keep it very simple. Just say your name, where you're from, what have you studied. And this is a nice opportunity to tell the interviewer what exactly your personality is. So maybe you can talk a little bit about your personality traits, about what you like, what kind of person you are. Are you a people's person? Being around people, you like to keep things very organized. You really value customer service and it actually makes you happy to be in a role, that is going to provide you an opportunity to provide customer service to people and things like that. They'll definitely have your resume right in front of them. So you can pretty much just walk through what you have put in your resume, about your work experiences, if you have any relevant work experience which you think you've got to mention to make you get this role, you can mention that as well. Next question is, what time will you be available to work at Kohl's? This question may sound very simple, but the answer to this could be very, very critical. What the interviewer wants to hear is you are available most of the times. You want to come up as a person who is very flexible, who has a can-do attitude and is really committed to the role if they are successful. So start with the times that you are available. I understand there may be times when you can't do it. Maybe you have uni or you have other commitments and things like that, but start off with saying the times which you are available. Another good thing to mention will be how reliable you are, that you can work maybe early hours when not many people prefer to work, you know what I mean, like early start, maybe 4 a.m. Also late finishes, because a lot of people don't prefer finishing late as well. So if you show that you are happy to start early and finish late as well, that is going to get you some brownie points. Most people like working on the weekdays, like Monday to Friday, and have the weekends off. So if you show that you are happy to do a shift which involves some kind of weekend work as well, that's very good. And you make extra cash too, because there's penalty rates on Saturdays and even Sundays. I think it's 38, if I'm not wrong, for casual, and 31 for permanent. And on Saturdays, I think it's 27 for casual, and for permanent, it's 21. Question is, how will you manage an angry or an irritated customer? This is like a sure shot question. I'm leaking the paper right now. They'll definitely ask you this one, right? They may rephrase it in a different way, but they'll definitely ask you this one, because being in the service industry, it is very important for them to know what personality you are. Like if there's someone who's very angry at you, who's abusive or things like that, how are you going to react? Are you going to fight back, punch back the customer, or are you going to stay calm and handle the situation very gracefully? So there are three things that you really want to convey to the interviewer, that you're going to keep your calm no matter what happens. Even if the customer is irritated or things like that, you're going to keep your calm and speak in a very soft voice so that the customer, you try and calm down the customer. So you're going to show yourself in a way that you have the capability to be very calm and handle such situations. You can also give examples. If you have ever been in a customer service role before, you can give examples of how you handled and calmed down a customer who was very angry. Giving examples actually gives an evidence that you possess this quality, right? So try and use as many examples as you can. At the same time, you also want to mention that you are going to follow Kohl's policies and procedures. Just because a customer is angry, you can't go ahead and give things for free, or can't give things, you know, just refund things or things like that. So you got to also mention that even if the customer is angry, you are going to follow company's policies and procedures and do what is the right thing. Next question is, why do you want to work for Kohl's and what do you know about Kohl's? So the answer to this one is definitely any interview will expect. If you're going for an interview, you want to come across as a person who knows where they want to be and why they are interviewing. So be prepared with the answer for this one. A little bit background about Kohl's, how many years they have been into the business and things like that. But don't go too deep, maybe just one or two lines about when they started, how many stores they have throughout and things like that. And more specifically, what you can highlight is your interest in customer service. You can also highlight how Kohl's gives you a lot of career progression options. If you have friends working in Kohl's or not in the same branch anywhere, you can also mention that one of your friend, you hear a lot from your friend who is a part of this organization already about how good the company is, how equally the employees are treated. Next question is, which department do you want to work for? So if you have a specific department in mind, just feel free to share that with an interviewer, that this is something where you want to be, but also come across as a person who is flexible to adapt. And if at all the business requires you to work in different departments other than your favorite department, say your favorite department is grocery, but if there is a business need where, you know, they need more resources to work in bakery or deli or, you know, produce or things like that, just say that you are very flexible and you want to learn the work that happens in different departments as well, and you're happy to move across and work across and have multiple skills with you. Next question is also a very short and critical question. How are you going to ensure the safety of you and others around you? Be prepared with an answer for this one. All they want to hear from you is that you are very familiar with the guidelines and the risks that are involved with your role. You're going to use protective gears when and wherever possible. And if there is a spill or anything on the floor, if you see which is dangerous for you or others, you're going to report it immediately and get that thing sorted. If you want to sound as someone who knows what they're talking about and has done some of the research before answering this question, you can definitely mention that you're going to follow a three-step process for to manage, you know, health and safety at work. So first thing is you're going to identify the hazard. You're going to assess the risks that could be involved. And third step is you're going to make an immediate action and change it. So like I mentioned before, if there's a spill or something like that, you're going to identify that. You're going to assess the risk that they may, someone can trip over it, someone can fall. And next step you're going to do is you're going to arrange that mess to be cleared up right there and then. After all these questions, a very important end part is the employer will ask you if you have any questions for them. Make use of this opportunity to shine and ask the right questions. Some of the questions that you may ask is, you can definitely ask about how soon this role is available and how soon are you expected to start. Next question is, you can definitely ask the employer that if you get selected, what is the employer expecting out of you in the first 3 weeks or first 4 weeks? So that shows that you are really already thinking ahead in the right direction about how you're going to achieve and meet the expectations of the employer. Actually, even ask the interviewer about what is their best thing, like what is the best part about working at Kohl's and why do they like working at Kohl's? So that also is a great question to ask. Guys, that's all for today's video, guys. I hope this was helpful. If you have any more questions, please leave it in the comment section below and let's try and answer all the sample questions and help each other, like I mentioned before as well. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do subscribe, and if you like the video, hit the like button as well. I will see you very soon with another video. Until then, take care. Bye bye.